In respect to issue of terrorism being funded by NGOs, there are no facts that has been put in place to ascertain that really NGOs are funding terrorism. There are allegations by the NGO Bureau Board that there were 15 NGOs which have been deregistered and their accounts frozen, basically because they've been funding terrorist activities. So far, the list has not been given to us. And two is that they have not been able to disclose these terrorist NGOs. Number three is we have our members. You know, NGO Council is a membership organization. And therefore, we've been waiting for our members to respond to us, saying that we've been targeted or we've been named for reasons they are not aware. And therefore, we are still waiting for the members, if they are members. And if they are not, then these are not NGOs, because NGOs are people who are there to serve Kenyans for good, not for any other purpose. Yeah. Our members are over 10,000 as of now, okay. Both in local NGOs and international NGOs. And most of them have been working across the country. Yeah. We also have have our members threatened to be registered for not complying with the law. We are, you must be aware, there were about 540 earmarked. But these are members who had been also given notices. Some were given notices in March, another notice was in June. But so far, we are telling our members not to panic, because those ones have no problem. We will deal with them, because the law has to be complied. That's what the government wants, and even us as a council, we want people to comply with the law. And therefore, we are telling our members they should come forward if they have an NGO and they have not complied with the laws that governs NGOs. They must submit their returns annually, and they should be able to give nil returns if they have not been able to have any activity going on, or they have not received funding. Also, we've had challenges with donors. Donors have not been focusing on the grassroots NGOs. They have been focusing on the national NGOs or international NGOs, giving them a lot of money, and they end up spending all the money in Nairobi without reaching the targeted person in the grassroots. And therefore, we are appealing to the donor world to be able to consider their mode of funding, or dispersing their donor funds, to be able to target individuals, organizations which are working with the society at the grassroots level. Most of these organizations are very small, and they cannot be able to have the capacity that they expect. But we are telling them it's possible, because if you build the capacity of this organization, they can be able to undertake any task, because these are the people who understand the real challenge that the people face at the grassroots. They are the one who have actually understands what the community wants, and not imposing on them. Many of these NGOs have been going there just on assumption that people need to be assisted, and they go in their mind on what they want to help, not understanding their problems. And therefore, we are calling to both development partners and foundations to consider talking with the National Council of NGOs, so that we can be able to redirect them to the right organization at the grassroots. We have now devolved the NGO Council. We have leadership at the county. So at the 47 counties, we have chairmen and their board. And therefore, it's even become easier than ever before to be able to reach NGOs at the grassroots. And these are people who are working with the county governments. You know, they are aware that the Kenya has devolved its governance system, and the county governments need also to be checked. So we decided to devolve those, bring together those NGOs at the county to be able to become a unit and be able to engage with the county government. Under my leadership, we changed our mode of operation, or modus operandi, and we are working with the government. We collaborate. We are not actually working together, but we collaborate in terms of service delivery to Kenyans. You know, our work is to complement what the government cannot, whatever the government gives and may not be enough, then the NGOs come in. We are actually patriotic, and we've been telling our members we're very patriotic, and they are patriotic, because in many circumstances these people come in when there are challenges, and I think that's part of patriotism that we're talking about. When people have problems and you come in and help, that's patriotism. In terms of bashing the government or engaging or trying to correct the government, yes, it's our responsibility as citizens of this country to be able to tell the government where they are going wrong. And the only way we've been able to communicate with the government is when they fail to come to the table. And then we go to the streets, and that's our right. It's in the Constitution. We are allowed to picket and demonstrate and be able to express our feelings. And in that aspect, I want to condemn the security bill, which is trying to curtail our freedom of expression at the venue where we want to express ourselves, because we must reach the target. And therefore, when they curtail us to a corner or to a place where it may not be reachable by the target person, then this is curtailing freedom of expression, freedom of association. And as an NGO council, we are telling Parliament today to shelve the amendments that they are putting in, trying to curtail the work of the non-governmental organizations and civil society at large. The reason why we are saying that is because when we want to demonstrate, like we want to tell Parliament or we want to pass some information to Parliament, we cannot go to Freedom Corner because Parliament will not see us. It's all basically the magnitude, but in real sense, of course, about 10 of them, of course, probably 5-6 will work, 4 will fail. So it's not all the time that when you demonstrate, you get your rights, but at least you have expressed yourself. It's a way of releasing also some feelings, and Kenyans also get to know. And then now the other way of engaging comes in through negotiations and other forums, and that's where we achieve our results. But in real sense, demonstration, picketing is part of the constitution of this land. Therefore, we cannot say it's an illegal activity or action that warrants curtailment. Yeah. We condemn with the strongest terms possible the acts of terrorism Kenyans have suffered in Mandera, in Lamu, in Pokot, in Baringo, in Turkana, Transoya, anywhere where there have been a lawlessness. And this is a very serious thing that we condemn all the time. We are only telling the government to be a bit stringent in terms of applying their security apparatus, because it looks like the police and the army don't correlate well. For instance, in Baringo the other day, when the KDF was deployed to be able to quell the criminality that was muted by purported cattle rustlers, whom we call them, actually they are robbers with violence. When the KDF came in, the police decided to abandon their work. It's because their relationship seems not to be doing well. And this has really left us without protection. And they must put in place proper means. The chief of staff, the general chief, the commander in chief should do something in terms of communicating with the two forces.